Dear learners, welcome to Certificate in Arabic Language Online Lectures. I am Dr. Muhammad Saleem, Assistant Professor Arabic, School of Foreign Languages, Indira Gandhi National Open University. Dear learners, you are learning some of the most important and frequently used Arabic expressions, Arabic common Arabic sentences you can use in your daily life. My effort is to help you speak Arabic language. And for that purpose, I have selected some of the most commonly used Arabic expressions. So dear learners, let me start with the first one. And the first expression that I am going to discuss is Ya Salam. Ya Salam. Ya Salam. Ya Salam. What is Salam? Salam is peace. You know, I have discussed this one before. Salam is peace. Ya, ya is to call somebody sometimes. Suppose you say Ya Rajul, O man. Ya Imra, O lady, O woman. Ya Khalid, Ya Ramu. Ya. Here you have Ya Salam. Ya Salam. So it does not have a literal meaning. Ya Salam means wow. Wow. Means if you find something really wonderful, beautiful, exciting, and you are really impressed with certain thing, you say wow. And in Arabic, you say Ya Salam. Ya Salam. So it's equally, you know, beautiful expression. And you can easily learn this one. Because Salam, you know, Ya is something you are familiar with. So there is no issue at all. You can easily communicate with Ya Salam. Ya Salam. Ya Salam. Okay. So now I'm moving on to the next expression. And next one is Uqaddir Hada. Uqaddir Hada. What does it mean? What is Uqaddir? Qadr. 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 Some people in speaking Urdu and Hindi, they say Qadr, Qadr, Qadr. Qadr means value. Value. Okay, value. Okay. So, Qadr. Root word is Qaf, Dal, Ra. Qaf. Again, Qaf, Dal, Ra. And Qaddara Yuqaddiru. You know, one meaning is to estimate certain thing. Estimate, estimation, taqdeer, estimation, okay. And uqaddir, uqaddir hadha, here the meaning is, I appreciate this. I appreciate this. Suppose somebody is doing something and you like the act or the performance or the outcome. So you are saying, I appreciate this. And the Arabic one is, uqaddir hadha. Uqaddir hada. So beautiful expression. Uqaddir hada. Uqaddir o qaf again. Always, you know, try to pronounce it in very, you know, proper Arabic manner and say uqaddir, not ka. Uqaddir. No. Uqaddir kadar, kadar will give a different kind of meaning. That means dirt, you know, dirt, dirt. Kadir, kadir is something dirty, dirt, okay. Or qadir. Qadir, that is again a different meaning, similar, you know. So, uqaddir, uqaddir. Then, if you want to have the perfect meaning, then of course it is this way you can express uqaddir hada, uqaddir hada, uqaddir. Okay, I appreciate this, I appreciate this. Next one is daqiqa min fadlika, daqiqa, daqiqa. Min fadlika, daqiqa min fadlika. What does it mean? What does it mean? Daqiqa min fadlika, what does it mean? Min fadlika. What is the meaning of min fadlika? Min fadlika. I have already explained this to you. You are familiar with min fadlika means please, please in Arabic. For please, the word is min fadlika. Min fadlika. Okay. And here, دقيقة من فضلك دقيقة من فضلك So see the pronunciation دال قاف Again قاف دقيقة And then من فضل ضاد ضاد This is not دال ذال No زا No ضاد من فضلك من فضلك دقيقة من فضلك Means one minute please One minute please Okay دقيقة من فضلك When do you say when somebody is waiting for you and he or she wants you to do certain things and you are completely you are super busy you are not able to you know able to perform so you want the person to wait for some time for you and you say daqiqa daqiqa min fadlika means wait for a minute okay so one minute please okay you say this is very common expression we use in our language also mujhe ek minute de dijiye thoda 2 second कुछ रुकिए इस तरह बोलते हैं वी ऑल्सो स्पीक इन आवर ओन हिंदी उर्दू एंड हियर अगेन दकीका मिन फ़ज़लिका सेम अरबिक मिस एक्सप्रेशन इज इन अरबिक दकीका मिन फ़ज़लिका दकीका मिन फ़ज़लिका ओके वन मिनट प्लीज ऑलराइट नाउ वी आर मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट एक्सप्रेशन एंड दैट वन इज उदरन 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 अला ताखीर उदरन अला ताखीर What does it mean? Udran ala ta'khir. Udran. What udran? Sorry. 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 You feel sorry. Okay. So, I am sorry you have learned this expression. I am sorry. And asif. Okay. This one is udran ala ta'khir. Udran. Udran. Sorry for ta'khir. What is ta'khir? Ta'khir. Ta'khir is delay. Okay. So, udran ala ta'khir. Sorry for the delay. It happens, in fact, many times when you want to attend a meeting and you are not able to make it in time, so you are late by a few minutes. So you reach there and you say, "Udran ala ta'khir." Udran ala ta'khir means sorry for the delay. Okay. So this is a very polite expression. It shows your personality, your ability to you know. As a good human being, you just say express your inability to reach and. As a good human being, you express your inability to reach on time and to be there in time. So you say, "Udran ala ta'khir," means sorry for the delay. Okay, sorry for the delay. Okay, so this is "Udran ala ta'khir." All right, dear learners, I think you are finding it really exciting to learn Arabic this way because you have plenty of commonly used Arabic expression and you are able to speak them without any difficulty. Here, I am just helping you to do that. You can practice a lot with the help of your friends and your other people and with anybody you want. Okay. Now, the next one is لحظة من فضلك لحظة من فضلك لحظة What is لحظة? لحظة ضو ضو round the لحظة is a moment M-O-M-E-N-T moment okay لحظة means لحظة من فضلك again you are very much aware of it من فضلك means please لحظة means moment so one what does it mean actually one moment please okay moment means one minute Same thing. دقيقة من فضلك لحظة من فضلك Same meaning. One minute please. Okay. One minute please. So for this one minute please, you have two expressions. لحظة من فضلك and دقيقة من فضلك. So both of these you can use for this purpose. Okay. So one minute please. All right. Now moving on to the next one. انتبه. انتبه. What is this? انتبه. انتباه. What is intibah? Intibah is you know, sometimes warning. Okay, somebody is warning you to be careful of certain things. If you do it, you will certainly be in trouble. So intibah, okay, this is kind of the warning that you pass on to somebody. And here it's a fele amr, so you are saying intabah, intabah. So you are here again warning somebody, okay, be careful. Intabah means be careful, okay, be careful. So it's a short one word. And one word is conveying the meaning, and the meaning is very important. Intabeh is be careful, intabeh, intabeh, be careful. Okay, so you can practice as much as you can with the help of this one. Now, moving on to the next one, you will find, okay, again, very common and frequently used one, and this one is ماذا يعني هذا؟ ماذا؟ ماذا يعني ماذا يعني هذا ماذا يعني هذا what does it mean or this mean what does this mean what does it mean what does this mean इसका क्या मतलब है वो हम कहते हैं इसका मतलब क्या है बार बार हम पूछते हैं we are in fact faced with situation when you do not understand certain things so you want other person to explain the thing and you say ما معنى ذلك ما معنى ذلك what is the meaning of that okay or ماذا يعني هذا what does this mean what does this mean okay what does this mean so through this expression you can ask for further explanation if you are not able to understand certain thing you will certainly say ماذا يعني هذا what does this mean okay now the next one أريد أن تكون سعيدا أريد أن تكون سعيدا what is أريد I have you know helped you practice this one أريد أنا أريد الشاي أريد الشاي أريد القهوة أريد القلم أريد الكتاب أريد البيت أريد المكتبة أريد الأستاذ أريد okay أريد means I want or I want to have okay so أريد this one you have practiced now again the same أريد أن تكون سعيدا okay all right أريد أن تكون سعيدا أريد أن تكون سعيدا what does this mean I want you to be happy okay أريد أن تكون سعيدا I want you to be happy أريد أن تكون سعيدا I want you to be happy okay it's very you know it's a good wish it's a wish for somebody in fact you like your relative your near and dear one you want to you should say أريد أن تكون سعيدا I want you to be happy okay it will really make the person very you know happy because this is a wish from your side all right so أريد أن تكون سعيدا I want you to be happy okay now the next one moving on to the next one and this one is أرجوك سامحني أرجوك سامحني what does it mean أرجوك again أرجوك just like من فضلك is please أرجوك again the same way أرجوك means please سامحني forgive me أرجوك سامحني forgive me or please forgive me okay so أرجوك is please سامحني forgive me okay so أرجوك سامحني okay a little bit you know I think difficult not difficult at all you can you know if you practice you can certainly master it أرجوك سامحني ميم ح سامحني please forgive me all right now moving on to the next one and that one is كن صريحا مع نفسك كن صريحا مع نفسك what does it mean be honest with you كن صريحا مع نفسك I think this expression I have already helped you practice again I am repeating كن صريحا مع نفسك صريحا مع نفسك okay be honest with you أنا صريح مع نفسي suppose in a different way I am saying أنا صريح مع نفسي I am honest with me okay this way you can change you know slightly and you can use according to the context it's all up to you how you are going to you know utilize the resources that I am providing to you so كن صريحا مع نفسك be honest with you all right now moving on to the next one محاولة جيدة Miss, what does it mean? محاولة جيدة, good attempt. What? Good effort. If somebody is making effort and is really able to successfully perform certain act, he is going to do. So he or she will say, محاولة جيدة. Miss, you are encouraging the person to perform. Okay? Or if the person is not able to even succeed and he or she has made a lot of effort, so in that context also you can speak this way and say محاولة جيدة good attempt. All right, so dear learners, we are moving in a really right direction and we are able to communicate, all right, to help you communicate in the ordinary life situations. So many common Arabic sentences that you have learned, all right. Through this, you can help your friend communicate and you can practice your own Arabic communication. Now, moving on to the next stage, and I am going to give you a practice. This one, just I will repeat the sentences or expression that you have learned, and I will not give you the meaning as I have done in the past. I will not give you the meaning. You have to guess it. You have to give the meaning. I will just read it in a proper Arabic way. You have to find the meaning. All right. So now I am starting it. Ya salam. Ya salam. Ya salam. Ya salam. Okay. Next one is ماذا يعني هذا. I'm not moving in that order, you know. I have just changed the, you know, so that the purpose is not to confuse you. The purpose is to make you attentive, okay, to pay more careful with attention to the things that I am saying. ماذا يعني هذا. ماذا يعني هذا. Okay. Now try to guess the meaning. Okay. Next one is أقدر هذا. أقدر هذا. أقدر هذا. Next one is دقيقة من فضلك. دقيقة من فضلك. Next is عذرا على التأخير. عذرا على التأخير. Okay. Next is لحظة من لحظة. فرضو لحظة من فضلك. لحظة من فضلك. محاولة جيدة. محاولة جيدة. أريد أن تكون سعيدا. أريد أن تكون سعيدا. أرجوك سامحني. Next one is أرجوك سامحني. Next one is كن صريحا مع نفسك. كن صريحا مع نفسك. Okay, so this way you have learned so many important common Arabic expressions and you have practiced also those expressions. You can yourself speak it as much as you can, as many times as you can. All right, now moving on to the next, I am giving you English, you know, expressions. You have to find the Arabic one. Okay, expressions remain same. Just I have just turned the table and now I am giving you the English and you have to say Arabic. Okay, so the next one is I'm starting. I appreciate this. I appreciate this. Okay, try to guess. Okay, go back to the earlier, you know, slides. If you're not able to say it, you can search there, but I will not tell here. I will just read English and you have to tell Arabic. I appreciate this. Okay, next one is 1 minute please. 1 minute please. Next one is what does this mean. What does this mean. Okay, question, what does this mean. Okay, next one is I want you to be happy. I want you to be happy. Okay, say the Arabic one. I want you to be happy. What is in Arabic? You have to say it. Okay, good attempt. Good attempt. Say in Arabic. I have already given you. Please forgive me. Next one is please forgive me. Okay, now based on these expressions, I have just prepared a simple para for you. Okay, based on simple expressions, simple sentences, and I'm speaking that you have to you listen it and try to find the meaning, or you speak the way I'm speaking. Okay, it is just for the sake of practice. All right, now I am saying كيف الحال يا رجل. كيف الحال يا رجل. كيف, see كيف, 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 how, الحال, you know, كيف الحال, this expression, this sentence, you have already learned it. And يا رجل, I have explained this one. يا رجل, يا امرأة, يا طالب, يا أستاذ. Okay, these kinds of expressions. So you are familiar with it. It's not a long one. It's not a difficult one. كيف الحال يا رجل. كيف الحال يا رجل. Okay. Try to find the meaning. Okay. It's now your duty. It's not now you are being, you know, your progress. I am trying to check your progress. So see it and find it. كيف الحال يا رجل؟ كيف الحال يا رجل؟ Okay. Next one is هل حصلت على الجائزة؟ هل حصلت على الجائزة؟ هل حصلت على الجائزة؟ What does it mean? Can you guess it? الجائزة, of course, that is the word, a new word, addition. I have not given this. الجائزة is prize. Prize, you know. If somebody is getting award, is prize, so الجائزة. الجائزة is prize. In a عام ملا كسي كو, okay? So, هل حصلت على الجائزة? You are asking somebody, هل حصلت? صوت. ح صوت. هل حصلت على الجائزة? على الجائزة, okay? Next one is, يا سلام. Okay, the first expression I began this lecture with. يا سلام. يا سلام, okay? Now the next one is, أقدر هذا. أقدر هذا. What does it mean? أقدر هذا. I need not explain it to you. It was already you are familiar with this. أنا سعيد بلقائك. أنا سعيد بلقائك. Okay. أنا سعيد بلقائك. This is very common expression. Everybody, you know, uses it all the time. أنا سعيد بلقائك. Okay. Next one is أريد أن تكون سعيدا. أريد أن تكون سعيدا. أريد أن تكون سعيدا. Another very good expression. You can use it. أريد أن تكون سعيدا. But I'm not giving you the context. I'm just simply giving you the expression. You try to find the meaning and try to use it as per your need. Next one is محاولة. محاولة جيدة. محاولة جيدة. ها. Always, you know. محاولة جيدة. محاولة جيدة. Alright. Next one is أريد أن أتكلم معك. أريد. This expression you have heard so many times. أريد. I want. Okay. أريد أن أتكلم. أن أتكلم معك. أريد أن أتكلم معك. Okay. I want to have a word with you. I want to talk to you. Okay. This is the meaning. I have explained to you. Okay. أريد أن أتكلم معك. Alright. أريد أن أتكلم معك. And now the next one is لحظة. This is not a ضاد. This is ضو. لحظة. In fact, round ta. And if you have تنمين there, تلو لحظة. But we are not any using تنمين here. No Arab, no vowel points. We are just, you know, simply without vowel points. We are just helping you speak. In fact, we are not helping you write it. So that's why I'm not there. So, dear learners, you see, so many important common Arabic expressions that I am giving to you, and these are the kind of the expressions that you can use in everyday life situation. You see, you encounter many people in your daily life and you need to talk to them, and these are the easy expressions that you can use. Because I am not any giving you some strange, unknown type of expressions that you may not be comfortable with. Here I am giving you very easy and common Arabic sentences. So, and the purpose of this lecture is not only just to give you expression, but also help you practice a lot, in fact. That is why when I am, you know, mentioning this, practice. What does it mean? Why I want you to practice? Because if you do not practice, you will forget. Okay? So here I am again going to repeat the same all the Arabic sentences that you have learned. Okay? Always be careful with the pronunciation. I am saying it time and again. Be careful with that, because that conveys a wrong meaning. You know, sometimes if you miss it, if you mispronounce, then it will certainly convey wrong meaning. So be careful with it. For example, كيف الحال. Okay, حال. You should not say حال. Ho. It's not ha. It is الحال. كيف الحال يا رجل. Okay, I am saying it slow. I am a little bit slow so that you can pick it up properly. كيف الحال يا رجل. Okay. كيف الحال يا رجل. And as I told you can say it كيف الحال يا طالب. يا طالب او ستودنت كيف الحال يا استاذ هاو ار يو او تيشر كيف الحال يا ابني اوكي اور يا بنيه يا ابني ابني ماي سن ذس اولسو يو كان يوز ات هاو ار يو ماي سن اوكي So you need not always stick to the sentences that I am giving. You can use independently your own sentences and you can replace it with some other sentence. It is up to you how you are going to practice it. I am just giving you examples and some samples so that you can rely on that. You can form your own sentences in the light of these common Arabic expressions. Dear learners, why I am repeating these sentences so many times? Is there any purpose? Yes. The purpose is to help you practice as much as possible. Okay? So that you can listen it many times and speak it. Alright? So, هل حصلت على الجائزة? Alright? Next one is, يا سلام. Okay? Next one is أقدر هذا. What does it mean أقدر هذا? Try to recall it. I have just mentioned it in the beginning of the lecture. I just gave the meaning. So please bother me not again to give the meaning because it will certainly may defeat the purpose. I wish you can learn it just by listening it several times. All right. So أقدر هذا. أقدر هذا okay always قاف أقدر هذا okay next one is أنا again I'm repeating أنا سعيد or سعيد both way you can say أنا سعيد or أنا سعيد بلقائك if a person happens to be female or lady you can say أنا سعيد بلقائك again like أنت alright like أنت أنا سعيد بلقائك okay this way you can express this one now the next is أريد أن تكون سعيدا oh very much similar to the earlier one أريد أن تكون سعيدا it's a nice expression okay if you wish somebody and if you really love somebody and you will use this certainly you will use this expression for him or her أريد أن تكون سعيدا but if you use it for female you will not say أن تكون سعيدا you will say أريد أن تكوني سعيدة alright أريد أن تكوني سعيدة A little bit, it's a grammar is involved. I'm not going to explain that. Just remember this expression that for female you will use أريد أن تكوني instead of تكونا أريد أن تكوني سعيدة. Alright. And again, the next one. Moving on to the next one. محاولة جيدة. What does it mean? محاولة جيدة. محاولة is effort. جيدة is good. So good effort. Commendable effort. Alright, you always say to the person who is performing very well, so or any act, so you say محاولة جيدة or جيد جدا you say جيد is good, جيد جدا very good. Alright, so جيد is a familiar word to you. Now محاولة جيدة, محاولة you have to make effort, محاولة is effort, جيدة is good. So محاولة جيدة good effort. Okay. Now the next one, moving on to the next one, I am going to give you أريد أن أتكلم معك okay أريد أن أتكلم معك أريد أن أتكلم معك I want to talk to you معك معك is there difference? Yes, it is different معك for male معك for female okay أريد أن أتكلم معك I want to talk to you if person happens to be female you will say أريد أن أتكلم معك okay معك with you معك with you female معي with me okay so this kind of the words or preposition words you have already learned in the earlier lectures or previous course you have learned it I am not going to that detail because that will involve the grammar points, grammar rules. Just I am giving you expression. Just focus on the expression. Uridu an atakallama ma'aka for male. Uridu an atakallama ma'aki for female. Okay. All right. Next one is lahza min fadlika. Lahzatun. You can say lahzatun with tanween. Lahzatun. But most of the time Arabs do not use this way. Lahzatun un all that tanween. Just while they speak, they just say lahza, 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 lahza. Okay, this is very commonly used kind of the pattern. Lahza, lahza. So lahza min fadlika. Lahza min fadlika. Lahza min fadlika. Min fadlika is something that you are familiar with. So many times I have helped you use this word. Min fadlika. And min fadlika. Min fadlika, please, please, please. You always say, in your life, every time you say please, please for so many things. Okay, so min fadlika is something that you are familiar with. Min fadlika. And ana asif, again, I should remind you when I'm saying please. Min fadlika. Ana, I'm sorry. Ana asif. Again, another word you can, expression you can always, it comes with that. Ana asif, I'm sorry. Min fadlika, please. These two are very, very frequently used expressions. So, dear learners, you have learned so many important Arabic expressions. You have practiced those expressions. Now it is up to you how you are able to handle those and how you are able to practice it at your home, with your friend, with your relatives, and with the person who knows a little bit of Arabic or who is passionate to speak to you in Arabic language. It is up to you to practice. So it is, I think, really exciting experience for you to learn Arabic language and enjoy Arabic language. Thanks a lot. Shukran jazila. Ma'a salama. Bye bye.